Now, the protests in Iran, there has been a huge level of suppression by the Islamic regime of Iran. Of course, we've reported that over 20 people have been killed. And now there are reports by some, including in the government, that says that 3,700 people have been arrested so far, and three people have been killed in prison.
Yes, and the condition of the political prisoners is really bad. There are protests daily in front of Evin prison, and other prisons across Iran and families are demanding that the loved ones are released immediately because they have committed no crime except protesting against the re-Islamic condition imposed on the people of Iran. People have the right to protest, and the Islamic regime has no right or legitimacy to arrest anybody on the streets of Iran.
سینا قمبری، وحید هیدری and محسن عادلی. These are three people who have been killed in prison already under torture. Of course, the regime is saying some of them committed suicide. This is nonsense. We know that after every protest, they do attack and try and torture and kill as many people as they can. So these protests in front of Evin and ongoing international protests is hugely important, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely, and they've managed to release some of the people.
The protesters
Absolutely.
Have managed to release. Absolutely,
they've managed to release some, but the fight continues. We know that the Islamic regime has Evin prison and many prisons across Iran, and the conditions are like Guantanamo Bay, or, you know, it is like bastions of Iran, effectively, that daily torture and horrible conditions are imposed on political prisoners. So we need to fight to bring this to the attention of the world and put pressure on the Islamic regime of Iran to release the political prisoners and the conditions that people are being imprisoned in.
Now, there's also a great deal of concern that there will be these sort of unofficial detention centers like Kahrizak, where protesters face sexual assault, rape, torture, and were murdered in these centers. So there is again this fear that in addition to the abuse that takes place in prisons, protesters are going to be taken to these unofficial detention centers.
We still receive reports of protests across Iran, and 20 people have died. Interestingly, the head of the army, one of the security forces in Iran, have actually said, we haven't brought arms out, otherwise we'll get rid of a lot of people on the streets and we kill them. But this is a lie, actually. We have evidence that the Islamic regime has used live ammunition against people and actually killed 20 people during the demonstration in the last couple of weeks in Iran.
And as we already mentioned, three people have been killed already of the protesters who've been arrested. We don't know the condition of many others. And there is a great fear that they're being tortured, facing rape, sexual assault, things that are quite normal in the Iranian regime, especially when dealing with those who protested against the government.
Yeah, absolutely. And we do remember the detention center called Kahrizak in Iran, that there are a lot of evidence that sexual assault, rape, and extreme torture was undertaken in this detention center. And Evin prison does exactly the same. Imposes the same condition on prisoners. And interestingly, one of the person who was in charge of the judiciary in Iran, which is very related and shows the face of the Islamic regime of Iran, Ayatollah Shahroudi, who was recently in Germany for medical treatment.
When he was in Germany for medical care, Iran Tribunal and others, including Mina Hadi, organized protests and also filed a grievance against him, a legal grievance against him for crimes against humanity that had been committed by Shahroudi over the 10 years that he was head of judiciary and also in other various positions that he's held. And, you know, I think one of the things about Shahroudi is that he is the personification of what the regime represents for people in Iran, the sort of hands being drenched in blood, you know, killers of children, executioners of children, and torturers.
Yeah, while he was in charge, homosexuals were hanged, tortured and beaten. Underage children were executed in Iran, and Kahrizak, that we referred to earlier, was under his guidance, and he was responsible for what's happened to a lot of political prisoners and young people and the students who protested in Iran were arrested and taken to detention centers, tortured and killed. And
these most recent protests in Iran, we've known, came soon after Rouhani's government issued its budget. It was anti-austerity, anti-poverty, anti-unemployment. It was for food, it was for work, but it was very clearly also about freedom and against the Islamic regime of Iran. Now, there are many who keep saying that it's only about food, it's only about austerity measures. It's no different from anti-austerity protests taking here in the West. It's very different because if you look at the protests, the slogans, fundamentally it is against all of the Islamic regime of Iran. No illusions towards the reformist faction, very different from previous protests. And I think it is the beginning of the end of the Islamic regime of Iran.
And we have no doubt about that. Organizations or newspapers like the BBC or the Guardian in particular, they've been the mouthpiece of this line of argument, which is actually the establishment line, that the current situation in Iran shouldn't really change. It's about mismanagement, economic mismanagement. That could be resolved. So you can't touch the institution and pillars of the Islamic regime of Iran. So that's a no-go area for them. So they're constantly arguing that it's about the economy. It's not at the body of Islam. And we have evidence that the people are tired, sick and tired of Islamic regime in Iran. Actually, the targeting, and they recognize the corruption, the economic mismanagement, if there is, which there is a lot of it, this poverty, this rightlessness, the workers' organization don't have any rights to protest or organize. All of that is linked to the Islamic regime. The fact that it is a regime that human beings are just the slaves of the religious institution and God Almighty, whatever you want to call it, and they are using the benefit, you know, they benefited from this.
What's very clear is that the people in Iran, on a mass scale, have said that they don't want an Islamic Republic. They don't want it. They want freedom, they want bread, and they want secularism. And that is the reality of the slogans that we see. It's anti-Islamic, anti-Islamic regime, and anti-austerity measures. Now, Jeremy Corbyn, The Guardian, all of these so-called left groups and publications that should be siding with the poor and the working class in Iran and instead are siding with our fascists and our Islamists, they are on the wrong side of history. It's about a protest movement in Iran that is fundamentally for universal rights and against, you know, the status quo. Everyone needs to decide which side they're going to stand on.
Yes, and we stand by the side of the Iranian people, and we know everybody wants to intervene and benefit from this. Trump wants to do that, Islamic regime, they try to a bit of a ding-dong between each other to actually pretend this is about the gay international power relations. Actually, the core of the issue is Iranian protest is putting all of these aside and is targeting the Islamic regime, and the friends of the Islamic regime in Al Monitor and The Guardian and BBC are upset about it.
Look, the people of Iran have spoken. Things might not change tomorrow, they might not change day after, but they are changing. Mm. They are changing, and that is a reality that can be seen very clearly in this protest. If governments in particular don't keep holding up this regime, how long would it last? I think that's an important question to ask. If the German government doesn't allow Shahroudi to escape and actually allows for him to be tried for crimes against humanity, how quickly will this regime fall? And I think that's what we need to talk about. It's not Western intervention against the Islamic regime. It's actually Western intervention in favor of the Islamic regime that has helped to prop up this regime for so long, despite its mass human rights violations. Well, people of Iran have spoken. The time is over for this regime. It's only a matter of time. So we need to side with the people of Iran against this regime.